So, Adrian has googly eyes on his drone. Comment down below a name for the drone, because I mean, it's obviously got an identity, just no name. What's up guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, and if you're not new, thanks for stopping by. Today I'm here with Aryan.
What's up guys? We are
in the farm. We are still complying with the social distancing laws. This is like 1k from our house. Today we're going to be testing out the Cudacopter Matrix and giving it
And for more videos, don't forget to subscribe, like, and hit that bell button. Thank you.
And we're going to be giving it our personal review. We've had the drone for about how long?
About a year now.
About a year. Basically, what we're going to do is, when we were looking to buy the drone, we couldn't find much on the internet besides from Cudacopter and a few other like channels. So we want to put something out there that people can click on, see if they like the drone, and give like our 2 cents on whether you should buy it or not.
We're not affiliated to anyone. We're just gonna give you our blunt opinion, which matters like 2 cents, I guess. So basically, Cudacopter is a South African company. They have a wide range of drones. This is the Matrix.
This is a fishing drone, purely fishing. So there's no camera on it. There's a new EX model, and there's obviously the old Vivo model. But I personally like the Matrix. It's a small, compact drone, very tough. Yeah, I've put it through hell, basically. I've tested it out proper. To date, my drone is running perfectly fine. I have crashed it a few times. It's still working fine.
It's float proof?
Yeah, it's waterproof. Fully waterproof. It has membranes in there to keep it floated if it does fall in the water. I mainly use it on the beach. There's no corrosion starting to happen. I mean, I've got it for a year. Quite impressed with that. Sand has gotten to the motors. I just come home or go to the garage. An air compressor, and I just blow the motors out, blow the sand out, and then it's perfectly fine.
So, Adrian has googly eyes on his drone. So comment down below a name for the drone, because I mean, it's obviously got an identity, just no name. Does it have a name?
No, we have it for 1 year, no name.
So there's no name. So please comment down below what we should name the drone. Here is the drone. It's got these little spongy things.
Legs, yeah. And then I slapped a GoPro mount on. I've never ever used a GoPro on, because we found out that it messes with the GPS signal and then the drone loses it up there, but I've never ever put one on. And then this is a string that attaches onto this server here, and then your bait will be hanging here, and then there's a switch on the remote that drops this, and then that slips off, and then your bait just falls off. It never ever came with these aerials. And then when I sent it back for the second GPS, then this is the updated version I've got. And then obviously you've got 2 lights for nighttime.
Do you know what the lights are for?
I do not know, he's a pilot.
So thingies here are lights, and one's green, one's red. So how we remember it is not much port left in the glass. Port side is left, and that's your red. So that's how you distinguish your left wing from your right wing. So it helps flying at night when you see the left is red, the right is green.
Just a normal plastic hard shell. It's quite tough. I mean, I've dropped it for like 1 meter high. Does it do it?
No, don't do it.
I'll drop it.
No, don't do it.
It's bloody tough. A lot of drones have fell in the water. It's okay. Mainly pilot, mostly like 90% or something pilot error. Sometimes it does happen because of the drone. It's very rare though. So enough talking, let's get to it.
Okay, so basically the drone comes in this box or the bag, carry bag. Like I did expect the hardcover, but he says
they have released a new hardcover and I think it's like R1,000 to buy it now.
Just like this, the drone comes with the battery.
It comes with one standard battery. It's a 6S and you have your two plugs here. This is just the fast charger that it does come with. Quite easy. Kutacopter does have on the YouTube channel how to work that. That's where I got it from. It did come with a free training. It's a 1 hour session training. It's quite good and helpful. And then you got your standard 13 inch props. Super lightweight, very, very strong. So battery just slips in here. And then your remote, basically like your childhood car, RC car, so it's basically that. So this, that's a very nice feature. So the drone can be out at sea and then you just drop that back up and then your drone will return to you and land in its own completely switched off. This is obviously your drop button. So you just drop it there and then back up. Drop your bait where you want it and there. Here you've got your calibration switch and then just a dead switch. When you start up the remote, I mean, it's going to give you warnings like that. Place all switches up and then ready to fly. Calibrate it and then... So remote always on, I made a big mistake and then the drone does its own thing. So remote on first and then the battery. Calibrate it and then we're going to fly it. Let's go.
So to prove how user-friendly it is, this is Aryan's drone. I'm gonna give it a go. I've only flown it like twice in the history of this 1 year. Let's do that.
Remote on first.
Remote on first, yeah.
Push this in.
Yeah.
Do I have to calibrate?
No, it's already calibrated.
Oh, what am I doing? Just kidding.
A bit dangerous.
At least if you screw up, we got it on video. It's getting quite windy now, eh?
You can see my hair.
Yeah, you can check his hair blowing in the wind. A little bit dusty. Hurry up, another truck is coming.
Okay guys, so we are done with the vlog. We got a truck in here ready to offload his cane. So we're gonna get out of here as quickly as possible. We're gonna end the vlog. The drone is an amazing drone. I would rate it a 9 out of 10. What would you rate it?
Yeah, roughly the same.
Roughly the same. For a South African product, it is one of the best fishing drones on the market, as well as being a South African product. We definitely give it 9 out of 10. Stats for nerds, the weight is 2.1 kilograms. Battery, 5,000 milliamp, 25 volt. Bait load it can carry is 2.5 kilograms. Number of drops you can get between 3 and 12 drops depending on the size of your bait. Fly time's around 28 minutes depending on the weather conditions. Remember, if your wind's quite heavy, then fly time's going to be slightly less. Your hover time with 0.75 kg is 16 minutes. If you take your fly time and your hover time, you can calculate with the size of the bait how long the battery is going to last. It is waterproof and it does have components to make it float proof. Your wind resistance is 35 kilometers an hour. So around 15 knots. So 15 knots. Anything above 15 knots, don't risk it. It's honestly not worth it. Especially if you're flying at the beach. We would ideally have liked to do this vlog at the beach, but obviously social distancing, and that's way out of our radius. So we came to the next best thing. Another thing, guys, is always obey your drone laws. For me being a pilot and him being a drone operator, often when we take off from Virginia, after that is the Umhlanga Lagoon and the Umhlanga Lighthouse, and you get a crap ton of drones around there. It is especially dangerous for pilots. I don't know if you know what a drone hitting a wing looks like, but I'm gonna just play it now.
The drone did not shatter apart. It completely penetrated and it was buried inside the wing.
So yeah, basically it's very deadly to us pilots. It is not safe at all, so obey your laws. And yeah, we're gonna wrap up the vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope it's of some value. Please drop a thumbs up, comment below, subscribe, hit the bell icon. So roughly a drone like this costs around 16,000 Rand. And at first we thought it was quite expensive and it looked a lot like plastic and stuff like that. However, when you actually get the drone and you use it, you really understand that it is a very purpose-built machine. So using it on the beach, heavy winds, bad weather, well, not bad weather, it can handle those heavy winds and carry those heavy loads. So, I mean, very well done to Kuta.
Comment anything you want to know more, if we can help you in any way, if you're buying one.
If you're buying one, feel free to drop a comment and let us know, and we will get back to you, especially Adrian. He knows a crap ton about it. He's researched it thoroughly before buying it. And yeah, hope you guys enjoy it.